Hey, what's up, fellas? How we doing? Matt Antonelli here. Today, just looking at some catch and throw mechanics of Yan Gomes from the Cleveland Indians. I'll play this through as we kind of talk about it. Check out our defensive playlist if you have not already. We've got a bunch of videos on catching mechanics, catch and throw stuff. My goal is to show as many major league guys as we can and just talk about what they're doing. Not so much about what I want you guys to do, but what they're doing. For me, they're the best. Most of them are the best catch and throw guys in the world. So, not all of them, but most of them. So, let's just look at Yan real quick here. I had a chance to play with Yan when I was with the Indians before they released me after about a month. But let's talk about his mechanics. So, first thing here, what I noticed with most major league guys is they're going to have that left foot preset a little bit out of their right foot, in front of their right foot. Sets their body up for one. For me, it helps free up this glove hand a little bit, makes it a little bit easier to get your left shoulder in front of your right. But also now, once you get here, you can get your right foot going towards your left foot and your left foot to the target really easy. You got to make sure, of course, whenever I tell young players to do this, I always say, well, now I'm not square. How am I going to block a ball? You want to make sure you don't go too much. But every good catcher that I've seen, every major league catcher is going to have that left foot preset a little bit more in front of their right foot. So you can mess around with it, see what feels comfortable, and then obviously can't be too far staggered, but you got to still be able to square up and block a ball. But from what I see, most guys are going to be set up that way. So that's the first thing. Once you get there, it's going to be footwork wise. If we just look at the footwork, it's going to be right to left to my target, so it's not a jump out, right? I'm trying to get my feet on the ground quickly. That's one thing Gomes does pretty quick right here. His feet are ready to throw really quickly. And again, with our guys, the quicker we've been able to get our feet under us to throw, the quicker the transfer happens, the shorter the arm action. Guys that usually take a big step out and they more jump, it looks like a small crow hop the second. Transfer ends up being slower. Arm action tends to be a little bit longer. So if you get your feet under you ready to throw quickly, everything else has a tendency to kind of speed up. If it doesn't, then we're going to talk about how to do that in a second. So again, my right to my left to my target. All right. That gets me squared up to my, in perfect throwing position. My feet are aligned, my left shoulder is on the target, and then I throw. Okay? So that's happening as I'm getting ready to transfer the ball. So I catch the ball, I bring the ball to the middle of my body. So they're working together. Ball in the middle as I go right to left the target. Usually my right foot is going to land right there as I'm taking the ball out, right in the middle. Again, I've watched a lot of catchers with this. This is one of those things where catchers try to catch and they try to bring the arm back and up towards their ear. And they try to transfer back here behind them, and it becomes a tough transfer. The timing gets messed up. And so if you just bring the ball right to the middle of your body as you're replacing your feet and transfer literally right at that Mizuno sign, I think that is on his gear, then everything times up really well. So it's transfer as my right foot's hitting the ground. I'm taking the ball out, my hand and the ball is getting up as my left foot lands. And now I'm in position to let it go. All right. And you can work on this. So Nick Hunley, one of my teammates back when I was with the Padres, been in the big leagues for a long time. I used to always see him just sitting there, literally working. He put the ball in his glove just like this, and he would just do this all the time. Like he was always just working on this part of it. No one throwing to him. I'd see him in the clubhouse doing it. Always doing it. So you don't even need someone to throw you a ball. Just put it in your glove and work on this right here. Then you can add somebody throwing a ball to you. Okay? So now once the ball comes to the middle and you break your hands, it's going to be thumbs down. So fingers on top. It's pulled back quickly. So now the arm doesn't go down low. So we tell our players again, if you're in water, if you're standing in water, just above your belly button, let me draw you some nice water right here. Some nice water. If you're in water up to your belly button, the ball should not get wet. It should be boom, quick. Pulled back, tight V, Again, this, that's going to stay tight. If you let that, the ball get down here, your arm straightens out, it's not going to be as quick, not going to be as powerful. So the ball comes up quick, pull back, now I'm in position to let it go. Okay, so those are some of the keys for me, some of the consistencies I see from major league catchers when I watch their catch and throw mechanics. Like I said, we've got a bunch of different guys, so you know, I'm not just telling you how Yan Gomes does it for me. I'm telling you how most of the guys in the big leagues do it that I see, most of the pretty good catch and throw guys. So hopefully this helps you guys out. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel if you've not done so already. Give us a thumbs up. Share with all your friends. All that good stuff. Check out the description box below. We've got stuff down there for you guys to check out as well. Check out our Instagram. We're putting videos up there also, Antonelli Baseball. And that's all I got, guys. Thanks again for watching. I appreciate it. Good luck to you as we get close to the season here. And we will talk to you later.